Before the big spring clean and purge, make sure you're starting out on the right foot. Courtney's joined by an expert with what to avoid when sprucing up your space.
Yeah, you know, we're getting excited because tomorrow's the first day of spring, right? So we're getting ready for that spring cleaning itch. But there's been some stuff we've been doing all wrong. Melanie Berliet joins us this morning with some of the top five mistakes that we're doing when it comes to cleaning. Melanie, I honestly... I tell my husband all the time he's doing stuff wrong, but you legit say that there's a wrong way to clean things sometimes.
That's right. He's not alone. You know, a lot of people start in the wrong spot.
Ah.
After you declutter, you need to work top to bottom. You don't want to clean your floors and then dust your blinds because you're going to have to clean your floors all over again.
Right. And I know you mentioned also putting off certain cleaning jobs because I would imagine the buildup is what's going to make it even harder to clean in the first place.
Yeah, you do not want to procrastinate when you're spring cleaning. If you set aside a certain amount of time daily, the task will never feel monumental and you're more likely to get it done.
Okay. What about using products? Sometimes we grab a product and we're like, oh, this will work. Not necessarily.
That's right. People forget to read the labels, and you really want to make sure you're using cleaning products properly. That means paying attention to the instructions to avoid damaging surfaces.
And that can apply also, you know, in this age of COVID with all the disinfectants and things. There are certain ways that you have to use them. You can't mix certain cleaning products with other cleaning products. Some things have to sit for a time to actually work. All that stuff is on the label.
That's a very good point. And there's a difference between a cleaning agent and a disinfectant. So you want to remain mindful of that.
Okay. How about using dirty cleaning tools? That makes me giggle, but it happens.
Yeah, I think some people forget that you have to keep your cleaning tools clean. Things like sponges, mops, and vacuums all need to be cleaned themselves regularly.
Right. I was taught that you can microwave your sponge for 2 minutes to zap some of the bacteria. Is that still a good thing to do?
No, I would not actually advise doing that.
Oh.
I know that's a popular internet hack, but in order to heat the sponge so that the bacteria is killed, you would essentially have to incinerate it in your microwave.
Oh, gosh.
So you're better off replacing your sponge more regularly.
Ooh, good to know. Jordan, our feelings are so hurt.
Sure.
Jordan puts his in the dishwasher. Okay, well, no, it's not going to work, Jordan.
Okay.
We got to switch it up. New sponges. And then lastly, the kids should probably help out.
Yes, it's a great idea to involve the entire family and to make spring cleaning feel like less of a chore.
I love the way you think. Melanie, thank you so much for your time this morning. We are going to link more information to our website, gooddaysacramento.com, under show info in today's date. Five mistakes that we're making, saving time. Melanie, thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right. Code, don't microwave your sponge.
I guarantee you I'm making more than five mistakes. Yes, Carol. She got a laundry list. All of a sudden, just like the whole thing goes goes all the way down.
Telling you, our wives need to get together.
No, they don't, John. You and I will not survive that meeting.
Maybe we'll live together. You and I, and they'll live together in a house.
We'll FaceTime them. How are you guys doing?